Assalamu alaikum everyone. I am Mavish Iqbal and I am MPhil scholar at the Department of Education at the University of Management and Technology Lahore.
Mavish, आप थोड़ा सा मैं आपको गाइड कर दूं.
Sure,
आपने ऑब्जेक्टिव बतानी है और मेथोडोलॉजी बतानी है और फाइंडिंग बतानी है.
श्योर सर, ऑब्जेक्टिव, मेथोडोलॉजी एंड फाइंडिंग्स. ओके, the topic of my study is lived experiences of research students related to research supervision at a private university at Lahore, and it is a qualitative study. I will move to the slide of research objectives. Basically, I used a framework of concept presented by Enley, and Enley used five approaches for research supervision. And basically, the objective of my study was to explore all those five approaches through the lived experiences of research students. So the very first one was to explore the lived experiences of research students related to the functional approach to research supervision. Second one was to explore the lived experiences of research students related to the enculturation approach to research supervision. Third one was to explore the lived experiences of research students related to the critical thinking approach to research. Next one was to explore the lived experiences of research students related to the emancipation approach to research supervision. And last but not the least was to explore the lived experiences of research students related to the relationship approach to research supervision. Now I will move to the slide of methodology. In order to answer the research question, the qualitative research study was conducted, and for this purpose I used interpretive phenomenological analysis. And the participants were selected by purposive sampling technique. Let me share with you that what interpretive phenomenological analysis was all about. Basically, it shows that how individuals perceive their lived experiences. This type of research provides a detailed personal view of an individual through the generic experiential theme interpical, supposed to be paired with the researcher's own perception as well. Interpretive phenomenological analysis draws upon phenomenology, hermeneutics, and ideography. This design research does not require a large number of participants, and basically the need of the participant as per this method is 3 to 6 participants, and for this study I used 4 participants for gathering information and discuss the perception of their life in my study. The qualitative research method was used because they helped to develop a compound understanding of participants' interaction with the phenomenon being studied, and the goals of qualitative interpretive phenomenological study method were deemed to align with the research questions. As I told you that I use purposive sampling technique, so it was used to select the participant, and this technique is widely used in qualitative research for the identification and selection of information rich cases for the most effective use of limited resources. The research site which I used was the private University of Lahore, and data was collected by the students of the Department of Education of the university. I used semi-structured interviews to collect data for this study, and normally in qualitative studies, semi-structured interviews are known as are used for collecting data, and it is and this method is based on interaction where through the dialogues the researcher adds questions in pre-planned interview form to probe information from the participants. And as per the structure of the study, where from fewer participants more data was expected to be collected, so the semi-structured interviews was considered as the most suitable option. Now I will move to the slide of the findings. As I told you that I tried to find the information related to the functional approach. of supervision. So when we talked about the functional approach, these themes were discussed with the participants. The very first one was about the selection of the research topic, and some of the participants, they said that they selected the topic and adopted the methodology of their own choice after discussion with their supervisors, while some of them said that they were asked by their supervisor to change the topic and the supervisor forced them to choose the methodology of supervisor's own choice. The second theme which I discussed with the participant was the match of the research area of supervisor and supervisee, and most of the participants, they were not aware with this notion. They said that their supervisors were so experienced, so definitely they had the idea about the topics, but they were not sure about that. Then we talked about the selection of the supervisor. The participants shared that they select their supervisors because of their previous experiences, as all the supervisors were the teachers of the participants, and due to their previous good teaching practices, they chose them as their supervisors. Then we talked about the supervisory meeting routines, where some of the participants faced management issues regarding this, as they were not directly in touch with their supervisors and not using any mode of communication other than face-to-face interactions. Some of them were highly satisfied with the meeting routines, as they said that their supervisors were very interactive and gave them wake-up calls if they won't appear for the meetings. Then we talked about supervisees' perceptions about guidance he or she were getting. Some of them were highly satisfied with the guidance they were receiving, but some of the participants said that they wanted to be guided more. But they couldn't convey that thing to their supervisor due to the lack of interaction and moody attitudes of the supervisors. Then we discussed enculturation approach, and the themes comes under this approach were supervisors' publication in supervisees' research area, where most of the participants said that they were not aware with this thing. They said that their supervisors were so experienced and guided them so accurately about the topic, and they assumed that they must have publications in that area. Then we talked about supervisors' active participation in conferences, where most of the participants said that their supervisors were fond of conferences and asked them to participate. Some of them said that due to their own personal commitments, they couldn't attend the recommended conferences. Then we talked about supervisees' ideas of becoming an expert in research methods, where most of them said that they could do research on their own. Some of them said that they are not getting proper guidance from their supervisors. So whatever they have done up till that time, it was their own effort. They also asserted that they were not comfortable with the recommended methodology, so they won't think that they were becoming expert in research methods. Then we talked about supervisors' help in locating resources regarding research, where some of the participants stated that their supervisors provided them all necessary guidance regarding this. The supervisors provided them thesis templates, articles, guidance regarding methodology, data analysis, and differences. But some of the participants said that they were not being facilitated properly. So whatever they were doing, they were managing the things on their own. And after topic selection and basic discussion, they tried to contact their supervisors, but they were not in touch due to university closure, and supervisors were not permitted to call them directly and contacted them. Then we talked about supervisors' guidance for the supervisee to become an independent researcher, where the responses of the participants revealed that some of them were very satisfied by the amount of guidance they were getting. But some were feeling hesitant in answering this question, as the amount of the guidance they were guidance was not satisfactory for them, because they were not in touch and directed with their supervisors. They had to make appointments for meeting and getting the feedback of the supervisors. Then we talked about critical thinking approach. Where we talked about supervisor style of cross-examining ideas of the supervisee, and some of the participants said that their supervisors cross-examined their ideas before finalizing the topics and research methodology. Some of them said that they had discussion with their supervisors, but they imposed their own choices upon the supervisees and were asked to adopt whatever they were suggested. Most of the participants of the study declared that they received very useful feedback regarding their work. They not only incorporated desired changes, but it also helped them to become more expert in writing and analyzing their own work. they also said that the feedback they were getting from their supervisor had helped them in polishing their skills as a researcher. They also advocated that they are becoming expert in research area and guiding other students as well, and some of the research areas are still needed to be explored, and they won't stop learning. When we talked about emancipation approach, there we discussed about the supervisor's way of providing feedback, and the participants, the ideas of the views of the participants were different regarding this phenomenon, as some of them claimed that they were getting feedback from their supervisors regularly and were connected through different medium of communication, and even during COVID they had interaction through Zoom or WhatsApp. On the other hand, some of them were totally lost, and they said that they are stuck and don't know what to do, as they are not permitted to call or interact with their supervisor other than face-to-face meetings. So that situation was very disturbing for them, and they said that it was very demotivating for their work. Then we talked about the importance of feedback on the disciplinary areas. Most of the participants said that timely and effective feedback is very important in all the areas, and it can help the students to learn new things timely, and no one can deny the importance of feedback. Then we talked about supervisees learning from the supervisor's expertise. All participants declared that they felt that they had learned many new things under the supervision of their supervisors. However, a few research students were desired to get more attention from their supervisors. Then we talked about the relationship development approach, where we talked about perception regarding research journey without the current supervisor. And most of the participants said that they didn't want to think about this phenomenon. Whatever the situation they are facing, they are satisfied with their choices. Only one participant said that if she chose someone else, for sure the research journey would be different. Then we talked about the communication with supervisor regarding research related issues. Most of them said that they had good relationship with their supervisors, so it was not at all difficult for them to convey research related issues with them. A few said that their supervisor is not easily approachable, and that is a big issue due to which it was difficult to communicate issues with her. Then we talked about relationship with the supervisor. All the participants said that it is responsibility of both the parties to take care of common values and give respect to each other. And lastly, we discussed about managing conflicting situation with the supervisor. Most of the participants said that they never face such situations. Some of them said that they never think about that, as their supervisors are moody and they are afraid that if they could take strict action against them due to any conflicting issues, so they tried to only follow whatever they were saying. Sir, should I discuss conclusion as well?
जी आप जारी रखें.
Recommendation बता दें sir. Recommendation पे चलिए.
जी sir. So based on the findings of the current research study, the following recommendations for policy and practices were made. So this study was revealed an area of research on which a lot of international studies are done, but in Pakistani context very less information is available. The next one is, this study was not planned to find irregularities in this field of higher education, but it is opened and unrevealed some unavoidable facts which are needed to be focused on. Therefore, it is recommended that universities must look into the concerns of the supervisees who feel not properly supervised and facing fear due to non-attentive behaviors of the supervisors. This study also raises questions about the management issues of the supervisees as well, where they are blaming the supervisors due to fewer interaction and their busy schedules. Therefore, it is recommended that higher education should make some policies for the supervisees who are just not completing their tasks and tasks and theses in time, and slots are not available for the deserving students. Sir, should I go for the suggestions as well for the future research?
No. Sir, we just dobara jaye recommendation ke upar. Just three recommendations are over here in your study.
Yes, sir.
So, isme se pehli do to hai hi koi recommendation jo pehle do words. अभी तो यहाँ पे दो रिकमेंडेशन मुझे नजर आ रही है ना.
सर फोर आर देयर. सॉरी थ्री आर देयर. नो 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 आई एम सॉरी सर थ्री आर देयर.
चलें जो सेकंड बुलेट पे लिखी क्या ये रिकमेंडेशन है.
नहीं सर, ऑब्वियसली इसके साथ कुछ और ऐड होना चाहिए था ताकि ये रिकमेंडेशन की फॉर्म में आ जाता।
नहीं, जो ये तो कुछ भी नहीं है, ये तो आप फाइंडिंग है ही नहीं, ये फाइंडिंग भी नहीं बनती।
सर एक्चुअली जब लिटरेचर रिव्यू किया गया था तो उसमें जो फाइंडिंग थी वो ये थी कि पाकिस्तान में इस टॉपिक के ऊपर रिसर्चेस नहीं हुई हुई हैं, तो रिकमेंडेशन में इसको इसलिए ऐड किया गया था कि इसी टॉपिक के ऊपर फर्दर रिसर्चेस रिक्वायर्ड हैं ताकि जो इश्यूज हैं रिगार्डिंग दिस टॉपिक
वो रिव्यू हो सके। नहीं 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 मेरी बात सुनी, ये तो फ्यूचर रिसर्चेस में आप लिख सकती थी, या आपकी डेटा से जो फाइंडिंग्स हैं उसके बेस पे तो ये आप बात नहीं लिख सकती ना। आपने तो ये बात पूछी को नहीं, मतलब जो रिकमेंडेशन होती है इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द फाइंडिंग्स ऑफ द स्टडी, और फाइंडिंग्स आती हैं जो आपने रेस्पोंडेंट से बातें पूछी हैं, तो आपने ये रेस्पोंडेंट से तो नहीं पूछी ना।
जी बिल्कुल सही, ये तो लिटरेचर में, जी लिटरेचर के बाद ये फाइंड आउट किया गया था। बिल्कुल ठीक है सर,
हाँ ये उसमें नहीं आती, तो ये सिर्फ मैं देख रहा हूँ, सिर्फ जस्ट टू रिकमेंडेशन है आपकी स्टडी के अंदर।
जी बिल्कुल सर, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल।
तो इसमें मेरा ख्याल है डॉक्टर साहब भी सुनते हैं कि इसमें रिकमेंडेशन ऐड होनी चाहिए, और ये इसमें
ठीक है डॉक्टर साहब, लिंकेज
श्योर सर, वो सर एज पर योर गाइडेंस हम उसको ऐड कर लेंगे।
हाँ जी, मैं भी, आपका टॉपिक बहुत अच्छा है कि इसके ऊपर बहुत के हवाले से जो है वो सुपरवाइजर क्या फील करते हैं, और अच्छा आइडिया और ये ग्रे एरिया है पास्ता के अंदर बहुत खूबसूरत है, और आई होप सो कि आप इसमें जो रिकमेंडेशन है उसमें चीज और ऐड कर लें।
जी सर, श्योर श्योर सर, वो मैं ऐड कर लूंगी।
जी डॉक्टर साहब,
थैंक यू।